Dear colleagues from the ILO and Global Social Economy Forum, dear participants, my name is Antonella Noya and I am the head of the OECD units which deals with social economy, social entrepreneurship and social innovation. I'm very grateful to have the opportunity to share the result of our recent work on initiatives and policies to boost social enterprise development, although I'm sad not to be in Seoul in person. The OECD has built extensive knowledge and evidence on social economy and social enterprises over the last 20 years, and it continues to provide policy orientation for governments and to share good policies and practices. More recently, it has partnered with the European Commission to develop a joint program of work to support social enterprise development, which includes a compendium of policies and initiatives, which was released last April. The compendium comprises 20 European inspiring cases. The lessons that stem from them can be useful also for non-European countries, as the challenges that social economy face are similar around the world. In our analysis, we looked at different policy areas, including legal and institutional framework, access to finance, access to market support, structure, education and skills, and as all these are relevant for the establishment of favorable ecosystem for social enterprises. Speaking ecosystem, I do not need to underline their importance, as you have spent the whole week discussing this. Still, I want to say that a coherent and interconnected ecosystem is more valuable than just the sum of its parts. And I would like to add that the process which leads to the establishment of an ecosystem is as important as the ecosystem itself. In fact, the more an ecosystem is co-constructed with all the relevant stakeholders, the more it is likely to be effective, well-tailored, and sustainable. There are 8 key lessons that we have developed. I will address some of them, and I hope that you will discover the others by reading the book. The first lesson is that it is essential to raise awareness and visibility of social enterprises and to address misconceptions. In fact, despite growing interest in social enterprises, policymakers and funders still have limited understanding of their specificity, and this breeds misconceptions. The visibility of social enterprises can be raised through a number of approaches and actors. The French law on the social and solidarity economy, FASE, a German financial intermediary, El Hueco, a Spanish multidimensional support structure, are good examples to look at. The second lesson is that strategic and multi-stakeholder partnership constitute a win-win mechanism for a range of diverse stakeholders. They can help social enterprises to enter public and private markets, build or participate in value chains, and gain access to complementary resources, skills, and network. Examples such as the Social Impact Factory in the Netherlands or SOBI in the Walloon region in Belgium provide some inspiration on what multi-stakeholder partnership can achieve to support social enterprise development. The third lesson is that fostering viable and sustainable social enterprises is essential. Again, this can be done through a number of approaches. Fostering social entrepreneurs' business skill and know-how is one of these. While identifying social enterprises' financial needs and designing appropriate financial support tools is another. The compendium provides good examples of these approaches, such as the Danish incubator Copenhagen House or the British program Big Potential. The fourth lesson is that fostering social entrepreneurship skills in the education system can not only attract new talents, but it is also a way to expand the boundaries of entrepreneurship as such. Policymakers play a critical role in designing and implementing strategies fostering social entrepreneurship education. As the French law on the social and solidarity economy and the Croatian strategy for the development of entrepreneurship, which allocates 28% of its total budget to educational activities, show. the last lesson that I want to present is that ensuring institutional continuity and political support for social enterprises is essential to allow them to thrive over the long term. This is needed more than ever today, as the world is undergoing dramatic changes. And more than ever, social economy should be considered as a key actor to address the challenges brought by this changing world. In this transformational period, it is essential to protect and enhance the territorial and social cohesion. And we know that social economy is very good at this. Digitalization is a potential game changer, which affects all sectors of the economy along with the society. While it is a motor for economic growth, at the same time it highlights the need to invest in people and their skill in order to focus all efforts on inclusive growth and to offset the negative consequences of it. Platform and open cooperativism is just one of the concrete ways that social economy adopt to accompany the transformation of our economies and target it to creating better and more inclusive society. Once again, social economies show its resilience and creativity to adapt to changing conditions and to provide innovative solutions. Thanks a lot for your attention.